I'm in a very random mood tonight. We're pretty, like, we've done a lot in this book, actually. I'm over halfway in this book, so if I can get another one done in here, that would be quite cool. Oops. Oh, got a mark. It's fine. Okay, so Summer Rain, whatever I do, needs to also use ink splatter because it's got some ink pick up from this page because I forgot to protect this side. Astral Fae, something Galaxy, Spring Fae, that could be pretty. Ugh, I hate how that one turned out. It happens. And then we have like these more in-depth ones. There's like a good chunk here that I haven't done. She's pretty. She could be quite quick. Angel Eyes. Let's work on that. Alright, let's start by adding in some shadowy, darker tones. So this is artwork by Christine Caron, and the current book that I'm colouring in is actually Colouring Heaven, which is a colouring magazine. However, Christine Caron does actually have books of her work for sale. So you can also buy the work separately. I've just coloured on the hair with the peach. That's okay. We'll fix that up later. Now we do have like a couple of light bursty things around here. That's okay, we can pull those back out with Posca markers or glitter or both or whatever we decide. Once we decide on a colour too. I am just gonna work through them for now because it's actually a lot easier to create a better blend. Alright, there's our base tone looking very peach, but that's okay. I just realised we probably are gonna need to blend more in here, especially when we add blush, because I do love going heavy handed with blush. I love my rosy cheek girls. So, a little bit on the nose, which we are going to immediately blend out back with our peachy colour we used before. we'll start blending out this bit as well. So we are using a very, very dry fruit pink to try and colour in some more areas. I'm still leaving a little highlight in certain areas. And then we're going to use this cotton pearl. We'll use that to help blend out some more as well, hopefully. Hopefully there's some juice remaining in here. So we're currently using, it's like a something white, eggshell. It's like E50. It's very, very light, but it will help us just blend out some of these pigments just a little bit further and help produce a smoother colour, which we desperately need. And we're going to really focus on these cheeks. Just bringing down this colour. So I'm using sort of like a smush action to help blend out these ends. And just make that blush be more blush-like. Let's get our shadow tone. So we're using our pale lavender, and using purple is one of my favorite things to do for skin shadows because that desaturation just looks so good for shadows on skin. So we just use this color to help place down, and then once again we're going to use a lighter color to blend it out, and this is Cool Gray 00. So not really a lot of pigment, but a lovely juicy marker for a start. Oh my goodness, it's so juicy. That'll just help us blend out this color. And now we'll start adding in our shadows around here. So I'm actually going to start with the lighter grey and just add some depth where we've already created a bit of tones. Just let it blend out. Alright, so I got a bit of shading around these eyes now. Blend that back out with our used warmer, but we actually want a bit of cooler in the inside of the eye as well. And then while we're here, we'll also use this grey to shade the whites of the eye, because they're not actually white. And then we will use our pale cherry pink to do the waterline. If there is any pigment coming off there. Right, so we're definitely, like, this is definitely reading more in shadows, but it's also receding quite a bit away and not reading as the same tone. So now we are going to use some of our warmer flesh tone and hope we can push it enough to cover. Switch to the chisel nib. I might need to do another coat with EO2. Just sort of, again, warm that up so it's darker but warmer. Yeah, so now it just reads more like her eyes are receding in, because they are. And technically this part would also be in shadow, but I've left that light because I am going to put some eyeshadow on her in the future. Once we decide what colour we are doing. See, part of me is tempted to do yellow, but I actually have a yellow one in here that I've already done. Got one in here that is, like, specifically everything is very yellow themed. Somewhere in here. I'm not saying, like, we can't not do another yellow one, but I really do like how she appears. So, let's just reach down and pull out a random color and hope it has ink. Whoops, okay, accidentally pulled out three, which is fine. So what we pulled out is a gray, which is great because it can be a shader. A grey. This is an old Letraset Pro marker in Ice Grey 3. We have an old Flex marker by Letraset in Pebble Blue. Oh, that's kind of pretty too. And then we have the colour Spice, which is a nice terracotta. I don't know about the terracotta, but I could definitely do it with blue icy hair. That could be really cool actually. Especially because we got this grey that we can also use a shader, and I've got my cool grey out, and even the purple, like all of that would work quite well if we did her hair sort of like blue and icy and went with a more like pure white themed. Yeah, I like it. See, if you don't know, just randomly pull. All right, so let's start by. In fact, you know what? I think we're just going to basically cover the whole here in this color and then shade from there. So let us pray that there is enough ink left in this marker to cover all the hair, because I already have doubts. Okay. Actually, I lie. Maybe I do have a colour. Oh, you like no colour at all. But you could work as a blender. So this is pale porcelain blue. It is B000. So the 000s have like almost no pigment. But to help smush around the pigment that's there, this could be very effective. Let us start using this ice grey to indicate some shadows. Now again, luckily Christine Karen's work does kind of indicate for us some of the tones, so we can just kind of follow and just bring out certain elements. Right, let's keep using these shadow colors. So we've already used purple on the skin, so we're going to use that on areas of the hair too. You can see just how pale this blue is, but we mix that with the purple. We just tie in this purple with the eyes, and she just has super light grey eyes. I think that's going to be so pretty. Just like a light lavender grey eyes. Together, and then this blue, we're just gonna take its very dead form, just use it to brush some eyeshadow over her. And once again, we will use our B000 just to sort of blur out those edges a bit. Alright, so I have a couple more greys. I think we're going to keep with this cool grey theme and do that for the feathers. So I'll start by blending that up. I think we'll use Ice Grey 4 as our medium. Yeah, it's definitely our medium. And we can use Cool Grey 3. Is our fill in. In fact, we can base all our feathers with this one just to make our life a little easier. now we're using our medium, which is the ice gray 4, to start adding in some sort of feather lines to show that these are feathers, and also some shadows. Now we have our dirk. This is where we need to be a little bit more pedantic. I'm using this dark grey to also cut back into previous feathers, so like the edges aren't just a straight line. Again, just creating that texture, that feather texture. Alright, so this darker grey, let's use it just to darken some of the darks. So we're not going for every, we're just kind of the darkest of the darks. I want to drop back down a bit. Definitely under the face here. We've got a bit of shadow. I need throat lozenge. Ugh. I hate that feeling of something being stuck in your throat. Alright, so. It gives us a bit more definition on the hair now. It's looking very grey. Now I know I do have some other light blues. You could work, what are you called? Dolphin blue. And we could do something very bright pink for the lips. So I do have slate. And doing like a grey could be really cool for the lips. That's cool, grey 5. Let's also keep that out. That's grey 5. Since we're here, we might as well keep these out. Cool, grey 3. Alright. Let us. Yes, hello, we found it. I knew there was one somewhere. Now, let us start going over, and once again pray that we have enough ink in this marker. Okay, here has ended up much more darker blue than initially intended, but also, I don't mind it. I like the smoky grey blue here. I think it looks cool. With like the light grey feathers, I think it's cool. So we're going to use the same dolphin blue in her eyes, just to add a bit more to her eyes. And then I'm going to do the same thing I did before with her eyeshadow with the blue. Focus it on the outer free corner. We are going to need to blend out this part. Scary point. That is a very grapey grey purple for the lips. She's going to have very much statement lips. Oh, I love that lip colour though. She's just gone from like, sweet and innocent to va-boom. I love that lip colour. Love, love, love. It's a colour I actually own and would wear and do wear. So we're actually going to use this Cool Grey 7 as our shader for the lip colour. Because it is so dark. I'm not going to do much shading. We are just going to define certain areas. Because most of the contrast in that will actually come when we add in the highlights with the Poskas. But that is essentially our base done. But yeah, I've just got these random paint sticks that we're just going to use to sort of go for it in the background. just got some Posca highlights and then some glitter glue to add, and this page is done. Awesome. Done. So obviously we're still waiting on things to dry down, but you can see the reflect of the glitters. I just love how shiny Stickles is, like, it's so shiny.